the writing process and me discovering who I am as an individual artist has really helped me become a lot more confident, which is nice. I can still be really quiet. Mm-hmm. I mean, put me in a room full of people that I don't know and I won't talk to anyone. I'll be the most nervous person on the planet. Uh-huh. But I'm getting better at talking to people, I think. And obviously I'm talking a lot more in interviews as well now. Mm-hmm. I don't just sit in the corner and hope the rest of the guys don't say anything terrible. So I'm now in control of everything that's said. It's done. I wasn't messing around, I'm not gonna lie. It was I had some stuff that I needed to write about at the start of the year, and at the start of January I was like, I need to get back in the studio, and it just happened so quickly. If I say so, I think I've done some really great work that I'm really proud of. I'm not going to compare it to Unfinished Business because it's different. There's moments on there that people are going to be like, whoa, okay.
In what way is it different from Unfinished Business?
I think it's very much a progression. I think my writing's obviously developing as well as I'm getting older. And I think musicality is obviously developing as well. And my voice is obviously still developing. I recorded a lot of the album when I was, I think, 21, 22. Now I'm recording a lot of this album as a 24-year-old. Or 23, 24-year-old. So I think people are going to see lots of progression in lots of different areas. I think it's just me really, truly, after Unfinished Business, really just knowing who I am as an artist. I'm really proud of it, yeah.
So we're going to call it Semi-Finished Business?
Yeah, more Unfinished Business. It's pretty, yeah. Be true, one plan. I love performing my songs that I've written. Mm-hmm. I think I enjoy that experience more because you can tell the stories during the show. You can be like, I wrote this song about this, and that's really special to me, to see people singing back lyrics that I've written from a very personal place and then relating to the songs and finding a way to connect their memories with my memories. And it's a really beautiful moment to see that happen. So I'd say it's more that moment than just performing or just songwriting. It's the moment where the two come together in other people's lives and affects other people's lives that I find just the most beautiful thing to watch. This is what I've seen on Twitter. I'm not going to lie, I had a little look because obviously some people were adding me in. Uh-huh. And I was like, what's this? And I was like, oh, okay, this is going to be fun. So no pressure. This crowd to make me find someone. Hold a snake. I used to have a pet snake.
Oh, it's nice.
Yeah, called Charlie.
Oh.
Really friendly name for a snake, right? So it's crazy what you got me doing now. Oh, that's really dark. I'd rather know. Oh, probably both. When?
When? Why?
Or maybe how? Because if it's if it's a really bad way of dying, then like you've got that coming and you don't know when it's happening. But then when? You're just counting down days.
Maybe it's how you can actually prevent it.
No. No, because if you know that's going to happen and there's nothing you can do to change it. Work on a secret artist, my favorite. Work on a secret project, my favorite artist. I think that would, because I'd hold that so dear to myself. That would just be the most amazing thing. Because for me, I'd rather be happy as a musician and knowing that I'm doing what's true to myself than kind of abandon what I believe in favor of like massive success. I'd work on a project with my favorite artist that's kept a secret. Because who knows, it could have already happened. Baby, come kiss me. I'd say a lover for life. Because when you've got a love like that, the price of pizza is nothing.
That's good.
He's an old romantic. Come to me. Kiss me quick, baby. Baby, come kiss me quick. Put your lips right. Create music that I love that no one could hear. every single time. Yeah, absolutely. I'd rather be happy than be unhappy doing something I don't believe in. Before you deserve it, you got me, baby, you got me, baby. Because if you live in the Harry Potter world, you can do spells and stuff.
Yep.
But I wouldn't want like some angry Pokemon coming to. Imagine encountering like Charizard, like going for a walk outside and like Charizard sat there. You'd be like, what on earth is happening? You're like walking around. Like, knowing my luck, I'd like come across like a really angry like Mew and I'd be like, or Mewtwo. Do you know what I mean? I'd be like, this is not a good situation. But imagine that would ruin your day if you encountered like a really angry Pokemon. Like throwing like flamethrowers and earthquakes at you, that's not fun. But Harry Potter world, however, the Harry Potter world, that would be really cool. I'd have my own little like pact and my own little team. I'd be like Harry, Ron, Hermione. I'd be like the crew, go around like saving the day and like, oh. Kiss me, creepy.